Okay, just a quick introduction to using your calculator. Mine is not exactly the same as yours, but everything I'm going to say is more or less the same. Let's have a look at doing these questions. First of all, just some basic stuff. When you're doing calculations, you want to be in menu one. So you press menu and type one is the quickest way of doing it rather than using this toggling thing. So let's do 2 to the power 6, 2 to the power 6. I showed this one because there is another way of doing it. I can type the number 2 in and then put multiplied by 2. You see the way it puts the answer up? That is the answer to the previous calculation. Multiplied by 2, I get 4. Now I can just press enter a few times and it repeats the calculation. Sometimes useful. Next is minus 3 squared. This is a classic that you're in a calculation and you're right. I'm quite happy for you to write minus 3 squared as long as you know what's going on. We all know that minus 3 squared is 9, but your calculator doesn't really know that. It doesn't really know anything, does it? It's just a little computer. So when you type in minus 3. You see there are two minus signs here. This one is called the unitary minus sign. That's what I'm going to use now. And this one really is subtract. So we're not subtracting anything here. This means negative 3 squared. And the calculator gets it wrong. So the message that I'm trying to get across here is to use your head. Why would you even type this into the calculator in your first place? Or if it was something a bit more complicated, I could go back and let's say it was 3.2 squared, which you do need to type into your calculator. There's no need to type that minus sign because you know the answer is positive. But if you do decide to type it, make sure you tell the calculator what's going on by using brackets. Okay. Let's solve these three equations. The top one is clearly a quadratic, x squared minus 2x minus 3. So I'm going to go to menu and then equations. It's in a slightly different place on the screen on your calculator. Now there's three types to solve. I'm going to solve a polynomial equation. Polynomial meaning an equation that has simple powers of x in it only, like this one. This one is degree 2 because x squared is the highest power. Your calculator will be able to solve cubics and quartics and such like. Mine only solves quadratics and cubics, but it doesn't matter because really the only thing you're ever going to solve on the calculator is quadratic. So let's choose that option. When you see these black blobs on the screen, they are referring to the F1, F2 buttons here. So I'm going to press F2 and I type in the coefficients. I've already done it. 1 minus 2 minus 3, 1 minus 2 minus 3. So you type it in and then you press solve by pressing F1 to get your answer. So easy. It will also solve simultaneous equations for you. So I go to menu equation. Okay. You sometimes see this, that you're trying to get to a screen but it's not going to the right place. The best thing you can do is press exit. Exit goes back through screens. So I'm going to go back. And here I am in simultaneous equations. Let's choose it, F1. How many unknowns have I got? 2. And so I can type it in. Now I've typed it in exactly as I've seen it. 1 minus 1, 2. 1 minus 1, 2. 1, 2, 11. 1, 2, 11. But notice that this is y minus x, as the calculator expressly says x minus y. But I'm going to do this anyway. Rather than rearranging, I'm just going to solve that. So this is saying that x is equal to 3, y is equal to 5. A little bit of common sense like that can save you time. Lastly, this is a cubic. I'm going to press exit to go back to here. But I'm not going to solve it as a polynomial. I'm going to show you the solver. So I'm going to go to F3. And you can simply type the equation in. So if I'll just delete that one. There's the equation. I'm going to type it in exactly as it reads here. I don't have to rearrange. X You see this button here, x, theta, or t. The calculator knows the context you're in. It knows that we want an x here. In other situations, it'll put a theta in, but not really on our course, so don't worry about that. X cubed plus 0.25 equals, now the equals sign on my calculator is here. Look for it. It is going to be a yellow one, shift. So I'm going to go shift point, and I get my equals sign, equals x. Run that. Now, this is not the answer. You press enter, you have to press solve. And I've got an answer, 0.838. Lastly, in this little session, is this. Let's imagine we're asked to solve this. Now, this is a simultaneous equation, but not in the simple sense. So the calculator, when I go back to here, this doesn't solve complicated simultaneous equations. This one, obviously, you could do it by hand, no problem at all. But the calculator will do it. Let's do it by going to menu and going to graph. This is really powerful. So I'm going to type it in, y equals x squared, and y equals 2x plus 3. And then I'm going to draw that. Now, when you draw it, may not look perfect. I'm going to screw up the V window, as it's called, just to demonstrate to you. Let's imagine it looked like this. And so you draw that, and this is very common that it doesn't really look on the screen the way you want it to look. Now here is the best thing to do, that when you see a window that isn't perfect, press V window and then press it again. And this will press the standard button. Now the standard button puts everything to minus 10 to plus 10, minus 10 to plus 10, and then you can get a feel for it. Now we're wasting a lot of the screen here, but it's not doing any harm. I can see where they cross. And so I'm going to ask the calculator to tell me where these two curves cross, and that is by use of this crucial button here. Always the button you press after you've plotted a graph. Press gsolve. And there's lots of things it'll do. It'll find a root, it'll find maximums, minimums, intercepts, and intersections. So I'll press that, that's F5, and it's found it straight away. Your calculator does it slightly better than this. Now to find the second root, I just move to the right. There's my second root, x equals 3, y equals 9. Really nice. Similarly, if I go back, I'm going to, I'll delete this one. Just change this one to something slightly more interesting. I'm going to move to the right and put, say, minus 2x minus 5, and I will plot that. So I can use the calculator to find the minimum, for example, by pressing gsolve minimum. Straight away, 1 minus 6, dead easy. I can use it to find the solutions or the roots or the zeros, and I do that by pressing gsolve root, and then to find the second one, move to the right. So quite a powerful thing. I hope you now know how to use it. Goodbye.